youngest of despots' daughters. After giving her sire a fresh baby girl, the despot's daughter will escape, hiding in the thick forest. Not knowing others like her live there in the forest of despot's daughters, she will faint when she finds her mothers, sisters, and aunties grouped around a fire, twitching and moaning. Their eyes have hearts beating inside. They boil whatever scraggly weed they find and drink the soup to see what it does. Poison? Miscarriage? Ecstasy? Tasty? Obviously, from time to time, during a slow period or election season, they will be gathered up and questioned by officers from outside the forest. Here's what the officials will ask. Have you ever avoided your duty as a daughter? Have you decided you're too good for us? Have you found something ugly attractive? Have you ever confided in outsiders? Familiar with interrogation tactics, having grown up with the despot, the daughters will lie skillfully. They will play the coquette. They will perform exquisite blowjobs. The officers will leave one way or another. During questioning, many daughters are accidentally drowned. The most influential despots have the officials lock their daughters into dark boxes and flown to an island no one can get to. They will be left there forever, or until the despot retires. The drowned ones' graves will go unmarked, except for a warning. A thin crescent moon lying dead on its back, stuck in the dirt on a popsicle stick. The moon is a symbol of where the girls came from before they became despot's daughters. The crazy forest ladies are thought to have flown down from the moon, which is why they must be questioned and why some must be drowned. They are dangerous in both their knowledge and lies. In their indiscretion and passion, the despot's daughters consort with four-legged beasts, not to mention the ones with wings and fins. Truly, they'll fuck anything they can, give birth to flopping things with weird patches of hair, flat eyes, one tooth. They must not be allowed to mate. Mutants will plunder the earth. Of course, mate they have already done. The despot's daughters are their own daughters, too. The forest is peopled by mutants who hit themselves and stink. They've inbred and become various species, texts, viruses curling sneakily through the bloodstream. They are tricky, the witches. They change shape, then fly to and from the moon, to and from the prison on the hidden island. They enjoy anarchy. They are bitter, will not take their meds. To get rid of them entirely, one official calculates. They will have to feed the old crones thousands of poisons for thousands of years, then pump in gas, then chop the whole forest down. One must burn them to ash, put the ash in a box, send the box out to sea with the garbage. Let it float up on the shore of the hidden island and rot, so the ones imprisoned feel lucky to be warm and alive in their pins. The despots report that they are unworried by these freakish women who choose to hide away in the forest, shaking their cooking sticks, squeaking threats. The despots say that these blights will burn themselves out of their own accord before they can do any damage. They are weaponless, pathetic. They say that the girls, illiterate and unable to record their own lies, are harmless. So let them dance and boil their roots. Let them ride through the nights on the backs of bright smears. What harm could they do but annoy like spiders or beggars? It's not like they have something anyone wants anymore after all. The despots repeat a prayer each night before